to our players, myself and the entire coaching staff are beyond excited to work with each and every single one of you. We're going to do this thing together. To our organization, get used to the mantra, all gas, no break. When we talk about all gas, no break, we're not talking about effort on the field. We're talking about the process at which we do things. We're talking about the way we prepare, the way we wake up every single morning, the way we rehab, the way we communicate, the way we speak to one another. Cannot tell you enough about how excited I am to work with this entire Jets organization and understanding that when we wake up in the morning, we will all, from top down, step on the pedal and find a way to get somewhat better than we were when we woke up. To our fans, we embrace your passion. We embrace your expectations. We cannot wait to go on this journey with you. Please understand, we understand that we have a lot of work to do, but make no mistake, that our goal is to win championships. And so again, I cannot wait to get through this journey with all of y'all. It's going to be an exciting time, and I promise that you're going to love what y'all see. With regards to the what's happened in the past, you know, what we do challenge everybody is to really judge us on moving forward. You know, when you look at the plan and what we have in place with regards to scheme, offense, defense, special teams, and the mindset at which we're going to do it, there's an investment that's going to be made to one another. Coaches to players, players to coaches, organization to everybody. And there's an investment that's going to be reciprocated. But understanding that the all gas, no break mentality that we're going to have with how we wake up in the morning, how we rehab, how we prepare for meetings, how we take the practice field, how we're deliberate in everything we do will lead to the results that you'll see on Sunday. It will take time, but everything we do is going to be designed to win championships in the future. And so when we talk about all gas, no break, and that mentality, waking up in the morning, putting your foot to the pedal, and having that mindset, again, go to bed better than when you woke up. That's the mindset we're going to have. And again, we are very confident that's going to lead to championships. Sometimes there's that notion of coaches coach, players play, and that's I've never taken to that notion. I believe that coaches and players are in this thing together. I believe that the investment that coaches put into players has to be the equivalent of the investment you put in your children. I mean, you got to invest everything you have in your heart and in your soul into those players because they're relying on you to help them be their absolute best so they can showcase their skills on Sunday. I think when players feel that investment and they feel that you're giving them everything you have, I think they can't help but reciprocate that investment and invest back in you as an individual. And so when you get that investment reciprocated and you got investments on both sides, it becomes personal. And when it becomes personal, it becomes very, very, very special. And I think that's the environment that we're trying to create here, to where everybody in the organization is investing in one another. Because like I said, when people invest in one another, you connect on a personal level. And when that personal level is connection is made, it is you just feel like it's a responsibility not to let that person down. And so, you know, that's kind of the mindset. That's what we want to create here. And it takes a lot of work to be able to get to those points. But again, there's trust involved and all that too. So hopefully I answered your question, but that's just how I see it. When you meet people and you talk to people, you can't help but feel authenticity. You can feel that. And so having that opportunity to visit with them, it didn't happen until I actually walked into the building and I had a chance to speak with Christopher and speak with Joe and speak with Jaime, and the way they interacted with one another and just observing them and how they interacted back with me, and there's that entire circle of communication, and you can't help but feel that connection. And so, like I said, when I walked out of the building, I was like, there's no doubt this is home. There was no doubt in my mind. It just felt like home. It felt like I was back home talking to my high school friends. I mean, it's home. And so to go into definition on how to explain that, the best way I could is it's like talking to family. And so I'm excited to be here. So, and I'm just humbled that they allowed me into their circle. Whether or not who has control, all those different titles, what's been made clear is that Joe and his staff want to be collaborative and they want to communicate at all levels. And so, every conversation that's had, obviously, with the staff and with Joe's staff, there's going to be a lot of discussions. There's going to be a lot of different things that are talked about. And so, obviously, Joe will always have final say. But I really, really see it in the way he's communicating. I think when you communicate at the level that will be had here, who has final say is irrelevant. We're hiring Mike LaFleur as our offensive coordinator. So he's been, everyone's familiar with the whole Shanahan system and what he's been able to create. Mike LaFleur has been with Kyle for, I think he's going on 8 years now of professional football, which has been his entire career. And nobody in the world knows it better than he does. And so to be able to have him and to get John Benton along with us as run game coordinator, really excited about them being able to install the system and implement the vision that we all want to see. A lot of pre-snap movement, a lot of help for the quarterback, run, marrying with pass. There's going to be a clear identity of what we're trying to accomplish down in and down out on the offensive side of the ball, defensive side of the ball, and special teams for that matter. And so really excited about the vision that we have in place for the offensive side. And there's no one better in the world than the people that we've hired to be able to do that. So it's going to be an exciting time for this organization. What I can tell you with regards to Sam is that he's got an unbelievable arm talent. There's a reason why he was the number three pick in the draft. He's fearless in the pocket. He's got a natural throwing motion. He's mobile. He's extremely intelligent. And like he's tough as nails. His reputation in the locker room is unquestioned. And so just that in general, there's a reason why he was the third pick in the draft. And you can see all those qualities on tape and around the building and the way people speak about him. There's a lot of things that we have to do moving forward. You know, we're just getting the staff into the building, so there's so many things that we have to do from an evaluation standpoint with regards to the entire roster, not just the quarterback. To give you that answer right now would not be fair. There's a lot of discussions that need to be had with Joe's staff and obviously himself, and so to give you that answer right now would be a bit premature. I'm not going to be handling play calling duties on defense. Got the utmost respect and confidence in Jeff Albrecht to be able to do that. I share the same thoughts as they do. I think the head coach and the message that is trying to be deployed to everybody. This is an organization that has to work locked in arms and work together, and to ensure that the messaging and the way we want things done all the way across the board is there, and maintaining that connection throughout, whether it's offense, defense, special teams, business to football, somehow, some way, everyone's got to find their connection to the player and with the mindset that we're going to get these guys better every single day. And to be able to have that focus and ensure that the entire organization is moving in the direction that we want, I won't be calling plays. So, and that is going to be the goal of this entire organization, is to make sure we do everything we can to connect to their well-being and to help them make plays on Sunday so they can get paid as much as possible. And that's, you know, when you look at the connection part with these players, there's an investment that has to be made. You got to sell everything you can. You got to give them everything you can. And when you do, like I said, the reciprocation happens. And when it does, it becomes personal. And that's all you can ask for, to get this to a personal level where everybody's got everybody's back and everybody feels accountable to one another.